What's going on, guys? This is Bruce with Gorilla X Retro Gaming. So today, of course, we're looking at the Retroid Pocket 4 Pro. You know, they have the 4 and the 4 Pro. I got the Pro Edition. And, you know, this thing is an amazing handheld, guys. And I tell you what, man, I have really been happy with this thing. I haven't played it a whole lot, and that's mainly because I have some other handhelds, some newer stuff that I have. That I've been looking at, but just having the time to go from one to the other, back to the other one. Right now, I'm coming back to this one because this thing is always a delight to look at. Even though this screen is not, it's a bit small. If it was the same size as the new Odin, this would be a perfect size screen for my eyes. Now, for anybody, people with good eyes and really sharp eyes, this is perfect. This is a perfect screen size. But I do hope, and I know they have something else coming out. Retroid's got another one coming out soon. I hope they start focusing on a little bit bigger screens, because I'm getting ready to start getting some Ioneo stuff, because man, they have some really good handhelds, and I don't really hear people talking about it a lot. But if you guys go on Ioneo's website, I think it's Ioneo.com. Y'all go on their site, man. They got some really, I think one of the cheapest is probably about $200 and up. And I think right now today they have about three or four different handhelds that's under $300. So, you know, and that's why I'm going to go over and probably pick up something in the near future. It'll be in the near future. It won't be right now, but it'll be in the near future. But coming back to looking at this thing, guys, it took me literally 10 minutes to put Lemuroid on this thing again, because I'm not completely finished with the RetroArch side of this thing in order to put like the ESDE front end on this thing, which I really do want. I also like Digisho, which is one of my favorites also. But I think I showed this thing here. I think I showed this handheld with Digisho, but after I did that video, I erased it. Wanted to start over because some of the stuff wasn't working, and I just want to make sure when I come back with it and I put it back on, it's going to be perfect, as well as some other handhelds that I have. So I'm still a work in progress with RetroArch, guys. It is really one of those hardest things that I've done to try to get everything focused in and to be able to do it without having to read other stuff to do it, you know. So that's why I'm feeling on that. So right now we're going to look at some, right now I'm on, PlayStation. I put 7 games on here. Ain't much, but just some of my favorites. Let's see if everything is set up. Okay, so see, this is not even set up now, and that's only because all I did was download it. Let's see something. I think this thing will end up going into. See, it's not showing my ROMs. Let me see if let's see. This is a GBA. All right, so let's go in here. Let's go into my ROMs. Let me see. Did I put a ROM folder? Oh, this is my whole ROM folder here. Let's see. PlayStation 2. And I think that was something that I probably wanted to do. So this one is looking for a specific folder. This one is looking for. Let me go back. Let's go back into here again. Let's see something. Now, as you guys can see, let me see something. So I'll probably do, let's go GBA, and I'll have it look into the GBA folder, allow. Okay, so I don't remember how many I put in there, but I know GBA will take a little bit longer than the NES would. Let's see. And basically, guys, it's just as simple as that. I can go back. Let's see if they have some GBA ROMs. Cause see, this is what I had on here. I had, I think I had a bunch more stuff on here. Let's go to GBA. It's showing 5 games, but I'm wondering if I did only do 5 games. Let's see something. I don't think so, but Blades of Thunder, Castlevania, Harmony of Dissonance, Desert Strike, waiting for operation to complete. So, yeah, so anyway, man, let's look at the stats on this thing while we sit there and wait. We'll look at the specs. I'm sorry. Retroid Pocket 4 Pro. The CPU is a 4.78 at 2.6 gigahertz. Clock, you got a 4 at 855 at 2 gigahertz. Your GPU is a G77 MC9 at 836 megahertz. You have 8 gigs of RAM. This thing is this thing is powerful. Now, it's as powerful as the first Odin Pro. So there you go. That just goes to show you, an Odin Pro, the first Odin Pro been out. Storage, but it's still powerful. Storage is 128 gigabyte UFS 3.1 TF card slot. Your OS is Android 13, which is really new. Let's see something. So you got a touch screen. It's a 4.7 inch. Like I said, 5 inches would be perfect. Maybe a 6 inch. You know what I'm saying? It'd be even better. And that is 750 by 1334 at 60 frames per second, 500 nits. Heat dissipation. It does have active cooling. 500 milliamp hours of battery. Analog L2R2. They are Hall sensors. You got Bluetooth 5.2 and Wi-Fi 6. Official OTA support for incremental software upgrades. So you will have upgrades. You also have HDMI out, so you can play this on a TV. And now, I don't know if you guys notice, they actually have a dock for these things now. And which are really intrigued, because the dock is nothing but $30. I mean, that's not a bad price for a dock. Matter of fact, let's look at this thing. I know you guys can't see it on my screen, but I was really really happy to see it. Something that just came out. Yeah, see, they showing it now. Retroid Pocket. And it's a pretty nice looking deal. Let's see. It costs. It says it's a 7-in-1 HDMI output, 4K, 60, 1 gigabit LAN. So it's powerful, guys. It's definitely powerful, and it looks really good. And it works. Let me see something. What is that? Yeah, that's the Retroid Pocket sitting on there. And it'll sit on this, right? This charger right here. This port. It'll sit right there, and it'll bloom on your TV, I'm sure. That's a pretty good deal, man. I tell you. And let's see, yeah, $29.90. So you'll probably pay with shipping and everything, probably about $35-$40, depending on the shipping. Usually be about $15, so that'll be about $45 with the shipping, which is not bad. It's a really, really nice looking and it fits the Retroid Pocket perfectly. So let's look at what we got, guys. I talked my way through that part. We should be good to go. Let's see. Circle of the Moon. Let's try Castlevania. No, not working. Gamepad detected. Settings menu. So I would have to go back in. Let's see something. Let me see. It's only showing, this is actually only showing one system. Let's see something. No. Hey, beautiful.